Hello, my beautiful people, and welcome to my summertime routine in the Bahamas. My wake-up time is normally 7:30 in the morning, and by the time as I get up, wash my face, do all my bathroom stuff, fix my bed, not necessarily spread it, but I fix it, I dust it off, I fluff up my pillows, I make it look nice, I spray it down with a deodorizer. That's what I mean by fix my bed, not make it, like I don't spread it or do any of that stuff. Then I get into skincare, and that's when I really like get my day started. Normally, I'm not hungry when I wake up. I'm not hungry right now. But I did go to sleep with a stomach ache last night, and I woke up with that exact same stomach ache. So I don't know. Honestly, I drink coffee with my breakfast Monday through Friday. Today's Wednesday. Monday through Friday is like some coffee, iced coffee, hot coffee. It's normally coffee because I save my tea for in the evening time, but I have a stomach ache. I have a stomach ache, so I'm wondering if maybe I should just go with the tea. But the plan was to make iced coffee this morning, and I've been thinking about this iced coffee since last night when I made up my mind to make iced coffee for breakfast or with breakfast. So I don't know. The reason why I get up this early. I have been trying to get into the routine of doing like some kind of morning movement, whether that's like a workout with weights, workout with body weight, some kind of stretching, watching somebody do something on YouTube or on the yoga app or something. I try to get my movement in the mornings. That way, like there's no distractions. I can stay in here, do 20 minutes of movement, or I can go outside and go on a 20 minute walk. But I have more options in the morning where I have nothing like really planned to do versus in the evening, which is when I like, I'm socializing, I'm going out with my cousins, I am like talking to my family. I like to keep those like times separate. So I get up in the morning to do my movement. So before I do that, because I don't know what I'm going to do, I just like to do whatever makes me feel good, to be honest. Whatever my body wants to do, that's what I do. But before I do that, I'm gonna clean up a little bit. I spend probably 15 minutes every single day just straightening up, if only my desk, because I spend a lot of time sitting here. What about a hit? What about a hit?
Thank you.
All right, so I am back at my desk with my iced coffee, half a bottle of water still, and my breakfast. And like you guys saw, it's just like one full egg and one egg white. I have like a little handful of spinach, two slices of Jennie-O turkey bacon, one slice of lactose free American cheese, and then some grapes and watermelon. And I'm just going to sit here in front of my iPad and watch a few YouTube videos while I enjoy my breakfast. Wow, it's 9:50 already. Finished my breakfast. I have like half of this cup of coffee left. I don't rush to drink this, honestly. Like yesterday I was still drinking iced coffee at like 3 o'clock in the afternoon, so I do not rush to drink this. I'm just going to put my lid on it just so like no bugs get in her. But yeah, I drink this one cup all day, but I do need to finish off my water. This is the kind of time in the day where I'm fighting the urge to go back in bed. Up until this point, everything that I've done has been like routine for me. Morning movement, just like getting me up, tidying up, having breakfast. It's like normal. But at this point, I've done all of like the routine things. So anything else that I do is specific to today, like it's special to today. I know I want to wax because, well, my legs are getting hairy. They're getting there. And then also, I have like legitimately, today's Wednesday. It's exactly 7 days, like exactly 1 week before I travel. And like I wax my entire body myself. So if I do one body part at a time, I can safely and completely get it all done without feeling rushed or pressed for time. So I will probably be waxing my armpits. Also, at this point in the day, I would have had my first shower because I just had my morning movement and I am slightly sweaty. But at about like 10 o'clock last night, I got the call to come in and babysit today. And I go and babysit. I have to be at the person's room for 4 o'clock. So I normally leave home at like 3:20, get there at like 3:40, get to the hotel at 3:45, and then walk to the room and get up there. And I like to be fresh for that. So I'm not going to shower right now. I'm probably gonna just push it back for an hour or two just to make sure, you know, I'm fresh and I'm clean when I go to work. So I'm probably gonna wax right now because if I don't do something other than like sit here and watch YouTube, if I don't do something, I'm going to fall into bed. Not accidentally, I'm gonna intentionally fall into bed. So, all right. So in the 40 minutes, that's how long the wax warmer took. In the 40 minutes it took for this wax to melt and be usable, I was able to edit a video. All right, so if you are interested, I use the Unicorn Fun Wax Warmer. If I can find it, I will link it down below. This one I really like because it came with this silicone insert thing. So once I'm done waxing, I just turn it off. The wax gets hard in the silicone and then I can pop it out and just throw the whole thing away. And it's like so much easier to clean up compared to having to like use oil and like let the wax and the oil melt and mix together and wipe it out. That was just a lot of work. This is a lot quicker. And it came with this 2.2 by 2.25 2.2-pound bag of hard waxing beans. It came with like 2 measuring cups because they give you like wax bean measurements. So just like go off of, I don't go off of this. I just use whatever I want to use, to be honest. It came with a bunch of popsicle sticks, some gloves, and I think that was it. My wax is warm, and I'm going to just show you guys how I wax my legs. Honestly, I do this so much that I don't want to say I don't feel pain, because I do feel hair being pulled out of the follicles, but it's not painful. Like, it's not like how some people are like cussing and carrying on. It's not like that for me, because I wax like every 4 to 8 weeks. I do it on myself, which I feel like I can handle pain better when I do something painful to myself versus having somebody do it to me.
So to some people, I probably like don't have a lot of leg hair. That's because, like I said, I wax pretty often. But like my hairs are, it's there. They're just very, very fine, which like makes them almost neglectable. But I want to get all those little fine hairs off. And yeah, hair is there. Some hairs are there. They're just super fine.
I'm tired, and it took me 20 minutes to do one leg, and I saved them to show you this much wax, all of these strips for one leg. So I'm now going to put more wax on and wait an additional 40 minutes to wax the second leg, because I have 2 of them. I have to wax 2 of them. And this is just like from the knee down. I ain't even wax my thighs, Jesus. Yeah. So I'm gonna finish this up. I probably won't get done waxing until like after 12, and then I will shower, and that'll be the end.